In this video, we are going to learn about this under voltage protection module, model XH-M611. Hi, welcome to product review by Watt Hour. This module can protect a battery from 8 to 80 volts, and this module can protect a battery from 80 to 80 volts when the voltage goes below the set value. So this is just for under voltage protection. You will put this between your battery and your load. So the power enters like that, comes through the relay based on the setting, and it outputs it. Right now it is connected to my power supply, to the battery. And as you can see, this is the voltage that we are reading. I just turned off the light so you can see it better. This is the input voltage that currently we are reading, and we have here a buzzer. There is a voltage regulator that can get up to 80 volts, and it will convert it to 5 volts to control this 5 volt relay and power the microcontroller and the display. So that's why, independent of the output voltage, it will work. But it needs minimum voltage of 7 volts at the input to operate. Below that, this cannot function. So it starts from 7 volts, but you can control from 8 volts to 80 volts. This has 6 settings that you can set. The first one, where we have here 3 buttons, set, plus, minus. When we press set, it shows the program. That is program 0. And if you don't touch anything within 5 seconds, it returns, or maybe 3-4 seconds. So press this. And now if I press plus minus, I can go program 1, program 2, program 3, 4, and 5. If I press again, it will be 0. Now if I press this again, now it shows the value for program 0. And it returned back. So program 0 and press again, that's the voltage. We can set the voltage where when the voltage reaches this voltage or lower, it will disconnect the output. Right now the input is this voltage is now 13 volts, and let me connect it. I've connected this load, so you will see the light. Also, this LED shows that the output is on. And now I'm gonna reduce the voltage. I'm just showing this twice. You can see, let me set it to 11 volt. So now the output is set with 11 volts, just wait. It will exit. Now, at 11 volts, it will disconnect the output. Now, there are other options which I'm going to test, but let's set, I'm going to change the output voltage. You see, I'm going to increase it. So I'm going to reduce it now to 11 volts. Now it's 10.9. And the output is off. This light is off and the load is now off. So this output does not have any power. Now let's go for the second, for the P1. If I press again 0, go up P1 and press the set to see the voltage. This is 1 volt, 1.1, or you can go up to 10 volts here. Let's go 1 volt, so it's quick, and just wait for it. This is the voltage when the input increases. You don't want the output to turn on unless it's 1 volt above the P0. Let's check P0. P0 is 11 and P1 is 1 volt. So 1 plus 11 is 12. Now, when the voltage reaches 12 volts, the output will turn on. So this is output voltage. Let me turn it. So it didn't turn on. You will see the reason. There is another setting that it says for how long the voltage should be on in order for the output to be turned on, because you don't want any voltage to go low and high to turn the output on and off. That's why we have a delay of 1 minute, and that is P3. So still we don't have it because it's I've set it to 1 minute. Just wait. Now it turned on the output. Now just P3. Press the set, go 1, 2, 3, P3, and then press set. It's 1. So you can go 2, 3, whatever minute you want. Let's see. Maximum 10 minutes. 10 minutes is very long time, so that's 1 minute. And it will exit. Now, P3 was the delay. Now, let's go to P2. P2 is the alarm. When the voltage goes below that value, the alarm will sound, this buzzer. P0, 1, and 2, and this is now 10 volts. Now, this will exit. Let me reduce the voltage to 10 volts or below 10 volts. Not only the output is will turn off, but the buzzer will also be triggered. As you can see, the output was disconnected, and now it's buzzing. So you know that the voltage went down. Just press this, and the buzzing will stop. Now still it's blinking because the voltage is lower. I can just go 11.7 or maybe 12 volts. So after 1 minute this will turn on, but don't worry. Now let's see P4. P4 is the power. When the power is connected, it doesn't immediately turn on the output. It has some delay. You can set it from 0 to 5 seconds. And let's set P4, press this once, 1, 2, 3, and then 4. Now press set to see it. Now it's set to 3 seconds, meaning that if you connect the power from the power, it will take 3 seconds. So let me turn it off. Now it's off. Even the voltage is, you see, I connected it. The output is not turned on. Even now, after 3 seconds, it was turned on. And now let's have a look at the P5. P5 is to control this display, to keep it always on, or from 15 to 30 seconds, you can set it. P5, set, go up, P5, and set again. AA means always on. But you can change this 30 seconds or whatever value you want, like that, 15, from 15 to 30 seconds. So now if we set this to 15 seconds, let's just wait. After 15 seconds, the screen will turn off, but the module is functioning. It's just sometimes you don't need this to be turned on, or maybe save the battery. For whatever reason, the screen can be turned off in 15 seconds. As you can see, if I press any button, it will turn on. If you want it to be on all the time, let's change this 5 and then press it, and then go. As after 30, it becomes AA. AA and just wait, so it would now it will be always on. Thank you for watching. This was the introduction to XH-M611. This is a very simple under voltage protection for the current of 10 ampere. Keep that in mind, that you cannot control higher current, because this relay cannot handle, and also these terminals are not suitable for higher current. So 10 ampere maximum is rating of this relay, and up to 80 volts this module can work for under voltage protection. Very simple to use. It's a good device to put it on the pad to protect your battery. If you found this useful, please thumb up and also subscribe to my channel.